Hi ladies, Jaki Sabrin here, and this is your date night video. And tonight I'm going to talk about how to deal with your BFs, GFs, how to deal with your boyfriends, girlfriends, right? And this is a really, really hot topic, and I'm so excited to talk to you about this because this comes up for a lot of women, and it came up for me, and I'm excited about sharing my point of view on this. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Jaki Sabrin. I'm an executive love coach and CEO of Engaged at Any Age, a company that helps women deliberately date and consciously create the man of their dreams. I met and married my own soulmate match husband, Michael, after being single for 8 years, and I'm still on the honeymoon and passionate about helping you get engaged at any age. And today I'm doing my live broadcast from our home in Utah in Deer Valley. And so I'm sitting on our couch here, and I have this view of the mountains where we ski off to the right and down into the valley off to the left. And it's just so fabulous to be here. It is just up in the mountains, surrounded by thousands and thousands of acres of trees, pine trees and aspens, and it's just so beautiful here. So I'm just so grateful that I did what I needed to do so that I can find my man, and that's why I'm passionate about making these videos, so that you learn from me to avoid the mistakes that I made, and so that you can avoid them and fast track yourself to attract your soulmate. And ladies, if you enjoy watching my videos and you find them valuable, you please do me a big favor, like my Facebook page if you haven't done so already, and subscribe to my YouTube channel so you don't miss an episode. It really helps me, gives me the encouragement I need, and inspires me to keep making these videos for you. Okay, so I'm going to jump right in with this topic on how to deal with your BFs, GFs. Okay, how do you deal with your boyfriends, girlfriends? And so I think it really depends on a few things, but let's start with what it depends on. So it depends on if you've dated them or not. So if your boyfriend has dated a girlfriend, so what I mean by a girlfriend is a woman friend. So when I say girlfriend, I'm referring to female friends of the man that you're seeing. So if you're the man that you're seeing and you're in an exclusive relationship or whatever the stage is, if you're dating him, especially if you're exclusive, okay, let's just say for the sake of the conversation, you're exclusive. So we're referring to your exclusive boyfriend or fiance or husband's the female friend. And so what it depends on is number one, has he dated them in the past? Does he have a history of dating them? They went out to dinner one night, had some drinks, and so even if they went on one date, I would say they are off limits. He needs to let those women go. And I think that's a hard and fast rule, and I'm really clear on that. If he dated that woman, then she is not his friend. That was a seasonal relationship. Yes, there's nothing wrong with having friends of the opposite sex, but if they had a romantic connection, then he needs to let her go. That's all there is to it. There's no room in his life for her because he has you. Because, I mean, when I look at me and Michael, he's my best friend. We spend all of our time together when we're not working. Of course, we both have our own interests, but really, I want to spend my time with my husband. I love spending time with him, and I always consider his feelings. And if I was to go out and meet up with a friend of mine who I'd gone out on a date with, I would not do that because I know that would hurt my husband. So my husband's feelings are a huge priority to me. And so if your guy is seeing friends of his that he's dated in the past, I would put him on notice that it's unacceptable behavior. So I hope I made myself clear on that. I'm really clear on that's a no. He needs to grow a backbone and either pick you or them. That's an ultimatum. And I never, ever, not, I can't say never now, but I usually hardly ever take a hard line. You know me, I'm very open, but that's just something that's not going to work. It's too confusing. It creates lack of trust. It creates insecurity. Yes, it's normal for you to be insecure if your boyfriend has girlfriends that he spends time with. That just doesn't mean that you're being exclusive. And so, so the next point is, if you didn't date him, if he did not date them, and they're friends, so it depends on the nature of the relationships. For example, say that your boyfriend has a neighbor she lived next door to him, and they've been friends for years because they've been next door to each other for years, but they never went out. And so they see each other in passing, or maybe she joined him and his friends, or they had a barbecue and she came over, but they never had a romantic connection. Then I think that that would be okay. And it depends on the scenario. If she said, hey, I'm having a barbecue, why don't you come by? Then I would expect your man to say, great, I'll bring my girlfriend. And I would expect her to say, fantastic, I can't wait to meet her. So if you want to include her in your relationship, I'm talking to you women, if you're okay with being friends with his friendly woman friend who he's never had a romantic connection with, I think that's fine. And again, it just depends on the relationship. And now if you notice that your boyfriend's friend that he's never had a relationship with romantically is really keen on him, when you do go to the barbecue, you're going to note it and be like, sweetheart, your friend has a big crush on you. I don't know if you've noticed it, but let's have a conversation about that. Because here's the truth. If she has a crush on him, he's not doing anything wrong. But here's the thing. It probably doesn't feel good for the neighbor lady to see him with you, right? And so why would he want to put her in a position, the lady friend, to feel bad when it's obvious that she has a crush on him? So I just wouldn't go there. So like I said, it just depends. But I would always make sure you're included, okay? And so the next thing is, what else do I want to say? It's just, it's a really gray area. And what I really want to say is that if you're wanting to be in a committed relationship and you meet a man, and if he wants to be in a committed relationship with a high value woman like yourself, then he doesn't have any time for other women. Sure, he can have colleagues and associates and they can go to lunch and even meet up for drinks after work in a group setting. All of that's all good because it's all a part of life, socializing, networking, et cetera, blah, blah, blah. But the gray area, if he's not telling you or if he's dropping it after the fact, then I would definitely have a conversation with him. He needs to get a backbone. He needs to decide if he wants to be a player and play the field, which is totally fine. But he needs to clue you in on that he wants to date more than one woman. Because in that case, you're really not exclusive. And some men do like to have a lot of women around them. And I say that's great, but he's not your guy because he doesn't want to be exclusive with just one woman. He might be saying, you're the one, I'm all in, I want to spend my life with you, but he's got all these women around him. So what that would tell me is he's got some kind of, well, I don't know what that tells me. It just tells me that he likes the company of multiple women. Now you just have to ask yourself and be really honest, does that work for you? Because I'm telling you right now, it doesn't work for me because I've been there. I've been in a situation where the man I was with loved women, and he liked to have a lot of women around, and he'd always talk to women wherever we went, and that really bothered me, and I became very insecure, and rightfully so. I was secure in myself until that happened, and I allowed it to continue by staying in the relationship, and I became more and more insecure, and I would say things like, you know, I think she has a crush on you, and he would say, Why are you being so insecure? And he'd put it back on me like I'm the one who had a problem. Like I'm the one who was doing something. And so it became really confusing. Like he would get defensive. And so I was always felt like I was being the one that was in it. Like I shouldn't have brought that up or that should be okay. But he was just trying to train me to believe that that's okay. And so it's not in my book. It's not okay. I want a man, and I want a man who knows what he wants. And I want a loyal man who only wants to spend his time with me because he enjoys my company, because he has fun with me, because I'm enough for him. He feels fulfilled with me. And I'm making sure that I'm taking care of my man's needs so he doesn't feel like he needs to involve other women. So, and you know, I asked my husband about this before the broadcast, and he said there are very few women that he would want to get together and shoot the, you know what, with. He just said there's very few women that he would want to spend time with. He just, you know, can't think of any. But me, isn't that sweet? That's what he said. So he's a busy man. He has a life, and that's why he committed to me, because now that part is all settled. We spend our time together, and we want to spend time with other people of the other opposite sex. We do it in group settings, and then it's really comfortable. And the bottom line, again, is no high-value woman is going to stick with a man who doesn't have a backbone, who doesn't know what he wants, and is trying to train her that it's okay to have women friends that are romantically interested in him, or he has had a romantic interest in or connection with that woman in the past. There's just no need. Oh, let's talk about high school and college sweethearts that you want to reconnect with. Why? I'm sorry, what purpose is that going to serve? Now, sure, I have a high school sweetheart that was just adorable. And of course, he was my first love. So yeah, the thought of meeting him again and seeing him, that'd be fun. But I would want my husband there. I'd be like, my friend's in town. And he reached out to me on Facebook. And I'd love for you to meet him if that's true. So do you want to meet for a drink? But I would never go without Michael. I would always include Michael. And if Michael wasn't comfortable, I'd say, you know what? Forget it, honey. I don't need to go then. But my husband would be comfortable. He's very secure. But I would only do it if he was my boyfriend from high school, was a stand-up guy and had no ulterior motive, but just to connect with me, meet my husband, hear about my kids and that kind of thing. So that's my, that's my take on this. And ladies, if you're feeling any uncomfortable feelings in your body about a man that you're seeing that is trying to pull this wool over your eyes, it's just don't buy it, because they're not going to be trustworthy down the road. So trust is gained in inches and lost in miles. Believe me, you will regret it. You have to create the boundary right up front and let them know how you feel. But make sure you do it with a feather. You can just say, as you know, maybe this happens and you hear that he was out and he met up with a friend who he dated before, and you might just say, you know, thanks for telling me. I appreciate your honesty. I really do. It means a lot to me. The fact that you met up with her makes me feel like I need to give this some thought. I don't feel comfortable with it. In fact, I'm going to need to regroup. I'm going to go home and regroup and see how I feel about it, and I'll get back to you. Let's see how he feels about that. You do a takeaway. So, yeah, you do a takeaway. You say, I'm going to have to get back to you. Not feeling good about it. I'm glad you had a good time. Thanks for the honesty. So I'm going to give you a little honesty of my own. It's not working for me. And so I will talk to you over the next couple of days after I've had a chance to process. So that's how I would handle it. I really would. There are times when you need to take a hard line, and that's one of them. Because you're not a doormat, and you don't want a man to walk on you. And he will if you let him. I'm not saying all men, of course. I'm just saying this particular type. And there are men out there that are like this. And maybe another woman let them get away with it, but you don't have to. And so maybe it happens once, and then he's on like alert. If he ever does anything like that again, you have to boot him. Because if he does it once, he might do it again. If he doesn't do it, he's not the kind of guy that does that. So there are men that do this, and there are men that don't. So there's different types of men, and you just want to find a man that doesn't. But if he does and he tests the waters, make sure you lay down the boundary and let him know how you feel right away. So I think that pretty much covers it. It's like a big fat no. Sorry, ladies, I'm taking such a hard line on this, but I know I'm cracking you guys up right now. Just that. It just doesn't work, you know? It gets too confusing for everyone. And we all need to stay in our integrity. We all need to stay in grace and honesty. And we need to be able to trust each other. And when you're hanging out with people, I call it that have a leaky chakra. Some women have a leaky chakra. And what I mean by that is they're kind of interested in your guy. And they don't got that under control. And you're like, you know, that's a leaky chakra. You need to button that up, girl. Because I don't want you around my man if you're going to act like that. Go get your own man. So you don't need friends like that, because you can't trust them. When you step out of the room, maybe they're talking to your husband or your boyfriend, and it's just like, I don't need that anybody in my inner circle undermining me. I need women who have my back and would say no, inappropriate to my boyfriend if he was to engage with her in a way that was inappropriate. You want to surround yourself by women like that. So if there's a woman in your group, I wouldn't say ostracize her. This is an opportunity to collaborate with women, not compete, but say, hey, do you have a minute? Talk to this woman, reach out to her, let her know how you feel. Come from love. Don't come from fear or anger. Just say, I just wanted you to know how I was feeling. It just, you know, this situation isn't comfortable for me, and it's not something I want to repeat. And I know that you're probably a wonderful woman, and you're going to find a great guy. It's just that my guy is, you know, already taken. So maybe you gently let her know what's going on and that you noticed that she's having googly eyes to your guy and to, you know, to button it up or hit the road because you want to be friends with her, but not under those circumstances. And to tell her that you can be a good support friend for her to help her find a guy, but she has to get her integrity in order, her house in order. And so, ladies, thank you so much for being here. I'm just going to now look at my chat box and see who's here and say hello and maybe answer some questions. If you have any questions, please, by all means. Hi, Pamela. Hi, Dinah. Dynamite. I love that. Just had my fun. Yeah, good. Yeah, you don't want to open the door to that. Trust is big. I will not do that to him. That's right. Trust is big. It's everything. And you've heard me say trust is a cornerstone of your relationship. So if you don't have trust, by definition, you don't have a relationship. And so right away, right up front, you want to address these things and nip them in the bud before they get out of hand. And then you do start acting like a crazy lady. You start like accusing him of things, looking at his phone. And there's other signs. In my next broadcast, I'm going to do all the signs that tells you he's cheating. I just thought of that today, and I don't want to go into it now, but there are so many signs, so you don't have to be paranoid, but there are signs, and one of them is if he's got his phone, hiding his phone from you, he's always putting it face down and keeping it out of your reach, that's a sign right there. Like, what's going on with that? What's the big deal about your phone? You know, what's so confidential that you can't keep your phone with the screen up, you know? So we'll get into that next time. Hi, Pamela. Welcome from Scotland. Nice to see you. Hi, Leslie. Hi, Jen. How are you? Ladies, I'm so happy you're here. Yay! Who else is here? Hi, Kelly. Hi, Megan. let's see. I had a guy who tried to make me feel bad about not being okay with him hanging out with one girl all the time. Tried to make you feel bad. Good job. Tried. And he did not succeed, I hope. Yeah, see, the men like that will try to convince you that you're the one who has the problem. You're the one that's insecure and jealous. But I say, no way, Jose. Hit the road, Jack. You're the one who's wanting to play the field. So go play that field and have a big old time, but don't. You won't see me on it. Okay, I have a sense of humor, I do. Because dating is hard. We have to bring some levity to it. We have to have a sense of humor. And but this isn't really a laughing matter. So I hope this is helpful for you ladies that are struggling with what your position is on this. It's a hard and fast rule. Get rid of them and find a guy that's got a backbone and some character to go with it, because he's going to expect that from you, because you have a backbone and you have character and you have values. And your values matter, and they make you who you are. You stand for something, and you don't fall for everything. And I really love a man like that, and I love women like that, who they know what they stand for. And that's why I create these broadcasts, to help you define what you stand for, so that you can feel really clear in those moments where there might be iffy. You can make a good, clear decision for yourself and stand in your word and your truth so that you can attract a man that does the same. That's why I'm helping you get really clear on what your values are and those gray areas, because the sooner you clear up any gray areas, because we've all made some mistakes in this department. I have as well. I've had a leaky chakra at times in the past. So I'm a human. I've made all these mistakes, and that's why I'm speaking from experience. It hurts people. And so the clearer you are about your values and where your boundaries are, the more comfortable and safe people around you feel. They know that you're trustworthy. They know you're not going to hit on their husband. They can trust you over in the other room talking to their husband, because they know that you're buttoned up. You don't have any leaky chakra. So that's so important, because you want the women that you surround yourself by, your married girlfriends, to feel safe with you. That's one of the reasons why when women get into a relationship, they kind of drop their single girlfriends. And I know that's really painful for a single girlfriend when one of our friends gets married or in a relationship and she moves into the couple's crowd and she drops you. Don't take it personal. It's really common. But she wants to be with the other ladies. And if you're really buttoned up, then she might keep you around. I have to take a sip of water. It's really dry at this high altitude. my favorite right now. I'm consuming these at a ridiculous pace. I need to slow down. My husband's trying to keep them stocked, and he's so cute. So I'm like, honey, I'm down to my last McCroc. Oh my gosh. He's at the store right now getting me a couple cases. I just love this. I don't know. No, I'm not getting paid to advertise this, but it's really refreshing. I think it's because the bubbles are smaller. It's easier to drink for a carbonated drink. And so, okay, ladies, it was great to connect with you. I'm so happy to do these broadcasts for you, and I hope you all have a wonderful 4th of July coming up next week, and I'm just wishing you a fabulous weekend, and I'm just sending you so much love right now. Bye. Hi, Michelle. Bye, everybody. Love you.